You know, I've been playing this instrument since I was 7 years old. And it all got started when my folks would let me stay up late on a Saturday night, all the way to 8 o'clock, and watch the Lawrence Welk show. I just loved it. I particularly loved the trumpets and the trombones and the saxes, and I always hoped that this week I'd be able to see my favorite clarinet player, a man named Pete Fountain. Here is a song now from Lawrence Welk and Pete Fountain, and if you listen real close, you might hear a champagne cork pop at the end. It's called If I Had You. Back in the 1930s, a pair of brothers got together and decided that they would form their own big band. Well, they did. One of them played the trombone and the other played the tenor saxophone. Now, the trombone player's name was Tommy and his brother's name was Jimmy. And their last name was, Dorsey. Well, they had a pretty good sound, but it didn't last for very long because, frankly, the two of them could not get along together. They fought all the time. They fought like, well, they fought like brothers. Here are two songs now from Mr. Tommy Dorsey. The first song is called Marie, and the second song is The Song of India. Hope you like it. Thank you. next piece of music now comes from Mr. Artie Shaw, who was one of my very favorite clarinetists of the big band era. This comes from a period in his career when he was spending most of his time in the recording studio and not performing live. Now, this particular arrangement not only featured his big band, but it also had a full string orchestra, as well as French horns and flutes. It's called Frenesy. Switch things up a little bit now. Do a little bit of country and western music. Oh, who doesn't like a country tune? Especially if it comes from Mr. Hank Williams. Now, I like this song in particular for its message. And I tell you what, I get up every morning out of bed and I sing this song to myself after I take my first good look at myself in the mirror. You should do the same thing. It'll make you feel a whole lot better. Hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we could find us a brand new recipe? I got a hot rod Ford and a $2 bill, and I know a spot right over there. I got cold soda the pop and the dancing is free. If you wanna have fun, come along with me. Say, hey, good looking, what you got?
at cooking. How's about cooking something up with me? Yee-haw! I'm gonna throw my date book over the fence. Buy me a new one for 5 and 10 cents. Keep it till it's covered with age. I'm gonna write your name down on every page. I said, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up? How's about cooking something up? How's about cooking something up with me?
Oh, you good looking thing.
Well, here's a song from Duke Ellington right now, and if you can go doo-wop, you can sing along.
What good is melody? What good is music if it ain't possessing something sweet? It ain't the melody, it ain't the music. All it takes is what you need to make the song complete. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Doo-wop, 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 doo-wop. It don't mean a thing. All you gotta do is swing. Doo-wop, 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 doo-wop. Well, it makes no difference if it's sweet or hot. Just give that little everything you've got. It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing. Doo-wop, 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 doo-wop.
Start playing music professionally back in high school. In those days, we mostly played for dances. And I can tell you, from a musician's point of view, there's nothing worse than swinging into the last four bars of a dance number and 10 people get up to join the dancers on the floor. So we got into the habit of sticking songs together into medleys. And as soon as I decided I wanted to do this arrangement of Perfidia that comes from Glenn Miller, it popped right into my head. The song that we always used to couple this with was a tune called Green Eyes, which was a big hit for Helen O'Connell with the Benny Goodman Orchestra. Now, I put it together as a rumba, but I think that they'll work pretty well together. So here we go with Perfidia, followed by Green Eyes. Thank you. wouldn't it be great to go on a road trip right about now? I'd love to get out across this great country of ours. And I know exactly where I would go. And I know exactly how I'd get there. Well, if you ever plan to motor west, travel my way on a highway that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66. Well, it winds from Chicago to LA. More than 3,000 miles along the way. Get your kicks on Route 66. They start in St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri. Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty. You'll see Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona. Don't forget Winona, King, and Boston, San Bernardino. Just take my timely tip. When you make that California trip, get your kicks on Route 66.
Two, three, I don't know, I'm going.
Well, here's a couple of songs now from Mr. Duke Ellington. I'm sure you'll recognize them both. Group back in the 50s and into the 60s that I really liked a lot. They were called the Mills Brothers. Here's a couple of their songs.
When it's so
a paper moon hanging over a cardboard sea.
Pleasure of working for 10 days with Mr. Louis Armstrong in San Antonio, Texas. It was something I'll never forget, one of the best honors of my life, and I really enjoyed it. This is a song that Louis wrote 100 years or more ago. It's a great old classic of New Orleans-style jazz music called The Muskrat Ramble.
Thank you.
Returning to the big band era now with the gorgeous sounds of the Glenn Miller Orchestra and one of the classics of the period. The song is not only one of the most beautiful and romantic ballads, but it means a lot to me because more than once on some of these shows, I've had a gentleman come up to me and say, "You know, I proposed to my wife while we were dancing to that song." Here it is from Mr. Glenn Miller, Moonlight Serenade. Swing era, the clarinet was king. And along with Benny Goodman and Woody Herman, Artie Shaw reigned supreme on this particular instrument. Now, Artie Shaw was a brilliant musician, a great clarinetist, but I always remember to honor Artie Shaw for his commitment and his dedication to the institution of marriage. He was, after all, married 8 times. To me, that takes perseverance, dedication, maybe a little craziness. I'm not really sure. But he was married to Lana Turner and Ava Gardner, so. I'm going to perform now Artie Shaw's classic, the piece of music he's most remembered for. This is Begin the Begin.
Begin.
return with me now back to the roaring 20s, the days of gangsters and flappers and bathtub gin. Here's a medley of great songs from the 1920s. See how many you might be able to pick out. About time for me to wrap things up. Thanks very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed my little presentation, and I look forward to seeing you all again real soon. I'm going to close as I often do with Glenn Miller's In the Mood. Thank you. everybody. Thank you.